the stunning ruggedness of the sunset in Rio. And it's quarterfinals day in the women's wheelchair basketball of the 2016 Paralympic Games. United States of America and Brazil go head-to-head, toe-to-toe for a spot in the semi-finals. This is a huge match for Brazil, potentially the match of this team's lives. The USA, well, they won the gold back in 2004 and 2008, so they've been there and done it in the past. So far in this competition, the USA are unbeaten, 4-0. They beat the Netherlands as well. The Netherlands very strongly fancied in the women's wheelchair basketball alongside the likes of the USA and Germany. For Brazil, they had a much more difficult time in Group A, winning only against the Argentinians. That meant they finished fourth in the group, which means they play the top team from Group B, which is the USA. The US will be in the white. The Brazilians will be in the green, no doubt. The crowd could be going one way here, mainly for the Brazilians. It should be a lively encounter, although for Brazil, they might have their work cut out on this one. The USA are very, very good indeed. They're a team who keep finishing fourth recently. The USA fourth at London 2012, fourth at the World Championships, both times to the Netherlands. They got revenge on the Netherlands in Group B. Here comes Bissa for the Argentinians. Evanilda Candida da Silva, or Bissa as she's known, a 3.5-point player. Through goes Perla. She's played fantastically so far. Perla, she was the top scorer against Great Britain in the pool, scoring 8 for the Brazilians. Claire is the number 7, Rosalia number 8. Rosalia Ramos da Silva, 1.5-point player, 46 years of age. Born in Recife. There's Jessica Santana just before her when Ana Aurelia Rosa, a 3.5-point player. Santana herself, 2.5 points is her classification. The number 11, she's got a good shot on her, is Guisa Rodriguez Vieira, or Gui, as she's known. 4-point player, born and raised in Sao Paulo. Not a million miles away from here in Rio de Janeiro. Number 12 going through, Liat Maria Suarez Martin. She's a good shooter. Hit 2 from 5 of her free throws against Great Britain. 13 is Maie, who top scored against the Germans. 14 is Paula Klorkler, who hasn't played much, but when she came in a couple of nights ago, she impressed. And then Vivi. Vivi is exciting. She's charismatic. She's kind of the talisman for the team. Look out for her this evening. She'll be wearing 15. They're coached, the Brazilians, by Martoni Sampaio. Here come the Americans. The USA, one of the most successful teams in Paralympic history, slightly overshadowed through history by the Canadians. Through the shot, there goes the number 11, Vanessa Erskine. Rebecca Murray, that's a name we'll be saying a lot this evening. Abby Duncan played well against the Algerians in a game they were expected to see off comfortably and did so. Christina Schwab is the co-captain, formerly known as Christina Rip. There's the number 33, Mackenzie Soldan. Soldan switched sports into wheelchair basketball successfully, as she's now playing off for a place in the Rio 2016 Paralympics semi-final. We'll now have the national anthems of both teams.
America.
There'll be passion and pride on court tonight and off it. Plenty of fans in from both teams. The Americans always travel strongly, especially at the Paralympic Games. And they'll be wanting tonight to put the Brazilians away. The hosts are playing for a place in the semi-final on home soil, though, and they know what that means. Their crowd, their supporters, their fans will be in fine voice. It's quarter-final time, Brazil versus the USA. There is the team list for the United States. Megan Blunk played well on her birthday in their last game against the Algerians. Natalie Schneider was great in front of the basket. Look out for Christina Schwab. She's a former wheelchair racer and five-time Paralympian, the co-captain. There's Stephanie Wheeler. She's a two-time gold medalist at the Paralympic Games. Very experienced coach, coached Illinois Champaign University. As well as, of course, the USA as they go for gold here in Brazil. Brazil stand in their way. Perla has been consistent for them. And Aurelia Rosa offers height. Lia Martin offers both height and power. And Vivi offers that little bit extra. That's something else. Coach Martoni Sampaio is the brains behind the organisation, working things through, thinking of the plays and keeping his team focused on what's important, and he will be tonight trying to unpick a way around the team in white, the USA. There is the starting five for the States. Geng, Hunter, Miller, Murray, Holloman. Miller, Murray and Holloman often the main point scorers for the USA. Look for the number 12, Rebecca Murray. She is one of the best outside shooters in the game. Faneas, Perla, Santana, or Jessica, as it says on her shirt, Vieira and Vivi. Leda Almeida, the number 15. She will be one of the leading stars for the team in green, the hosts, here in Rio de Janeiro, the 2016 Paralympic Games. It's the women's quarterfinal. USA have gone 4-0 so far. France, China, Netherlands and Algeria all seen off with some comfort. Just 10 points between them and the Netherlands, as two of the top teams in the competition went head-to-head in Group B. For Brazil, it was 1-3 in Group A as they beat Argentina and then were seen off with some comfort by the Germans, the British and the Canadians. Well, we're underway. Brazil got the tap, got the ball way back in their own court. The referee for this one, throwing the ball up there, was Max Kindervater. He's supported by umpire Saskia Varmadam and Alexandra Lapon. In goes Faleas. She was not far away there. And 100% of her field goals against Great Britain in the group stages. Just 2 from 2. Comfortable stuff from the number 15, Holloman. Holloman, a big points player for her team. In that match against the Netherlands, she hit 17. The Netherlands, not an easy team to put away, and the USA managed it in some comfort in the end. 10 points the difference. Vivi looks for the One-handed shot, misses everything. Vieira caught it, may wish she didn't because she rushed against the shot and gets the shot away well. Holloman with the defensive rebound early in this one. Women's quarter-final, USA 2, Brazil 0. Miller plays for the Milwaukee Bucks in the American National Wheelchair Basketball League. 4-0 the score. Miller often underweight for her scoring. Vivi. Eyes up from Vivi. Tries to find a way around Desi Miller. Miller reaching and stretching every sinew that her left arm will offer her. Rebecca Murray comes across the shot to inbound the ball. One of the world's greatest players currently, Murray. Hits so many shots that you really wouldn't expect and has the most unbelievable technique. Here's Rose Holloman, finds Murray. Murray, oh, and as I say that, commentator's curse on Murray. I apologise, Rebecca. 4-0 the score remains. Brazil chasing the game early on. Vivi finds Jessica. Two players who have been live wires for the Brazilians in this competition. Falias drops it back. Well caught there. Vivi over the shoulder of Desi Miller. The shot clock ticks down and the Brazilians at the moment just cannot find the basket. Geng, who is co-captain of this USA side. They break away, and it's that lady, Rose Holloman. She competed at London 2012, still only young though, Holloman. Just 20 years of age, so 16 at London 2012. 6-0 the US lead, it stays 6-0. Vivi and Holloman battle for the board, and Saskia Varmadam, who hails from the Netherlands, signals it will be an American ball. In comes Klokler, now a player who has been rarely used in this competition, but has shown some fight when she's come in for Brazil. She's going to have to fight here. She's 6-0 down currently against the US. Lovely pass. Geng off the glass for two. No mistakes. The assist from Holloman was simple. Geng, 19.4 minutes per game at the Pan Am Games last year in Toronto, where the US qualified for the showpiece of wheelchair basketball, the Paralympic Games. Vivi gets them underway, the Brazilians, and the fans respond with delight. Geng, Holloman, Vivi playing her the closest of attention. Murray. Long two, look at that. That's exactly what I was talking about with Rebecca Murray's shooting. She is so consistent, so often. And again under, and again it goes for Murray. She only hit 8 points against the Algerians at 40%. She's already out to 4 points personal for the game here. And she will have a chance at a fifth. The Brazilians make a change. In comes Martin, Leah Martin. Murray waits to shoot. She's missed one this evening. She's on 4 points personal, her first free throw of the game. And she makes it look so, so simple. There is no complication to the game of Rebecca Murray. Been around the game for a long, long time. Now won gold in 2007. Pan Am Games in Rio, and she returns here aiming for the semi-finals and more for the USA. That's going nowhere for Martin, and the Brazilians just limited to pot shots currently. 13-2 USA lead. Rose Holloman spins out. Murray setting the pick on Klokler. Here's Desi Miller, languid style, relaxed, like she's playing on a court at home. No pressure. The shot, though, came under some, and she couldn't put it away. And the number nine then turns around and keeps Leah back in the backcourt. Jessica, what a catch that was. up and down from Jessica, nothing coming. Leah, Jessica once more. Paula has been in there a long time, needs to come out and does so. Perla, up and down from her with no interest added. 11 points versus Argentina for the number six tonight versus the USA, a totally different prospect, and Holloman proves just that as she drops the two for the team in white. The USA, number four in the world from the World Championships at 2014, and they're currently leading the Brazilians 15 points to two. The Brazilians are still pumped up though. They might be behind by 13. They might be struggling to keep Rose Holloman quiet. But they're not alone there. Many other teams have, many other countries do. 47% of field goals successful for Holloman against the Netherlands. So Brazil are not alone. We rejoin the game. 15-2 the score from the timeout. Vivi, Jessica. The all-round game of the Brazilians has improved beyond measure into this competition, and even through the competition, where they fall down time and again, and it's happened across basketball. The shot goes up and Miller can't get any points. The Brazilian shot is nowhere near as accurate as the top teams. It's something they can work on for future games, if they go no further than this evening, which at the moment it's looking unlikely, but still early stages. Vivi. Out to Jessica. Jessica one-handed, and that's exactly what I'm talking about. That pressure on the shot and the technique goes, and the Brazilians just unable to beat the shot clock and add the two, which is something that the likes of Holloman, Miller and the USA will be very good at come the pressure games, the semi-finals or finals or bronze medal matches in the Paralympics, if they get there. Let's not count our chickens. Holloman up, misses, and just as I say how successful the US are at taking difficult shots, Holloman decides to go against that form. Here comes Vivi spinning in and out and then going a long way clear as Perla cuts across. Jessica handling the ball well this evening. 3:20 to go in the first. Murray. Holloman. Geng, lovely pass to Rebecca Murray. She'll go for the shot herself and just affects the ring slightly as the ball just spun round briefly and then dropped kindly for the number 12, 2.5-point player. Just 26 years of age, Rebecca Murray. Seems like she's been around for decades almost. Klokla to Jessica. Again, the shot clock dying away on the Brazilians, and again, the shot fails for them, and Murray slow to get going. When she does, she's a quick player. The guard cuts inside a Klokler under pressure from Jessica, and she knows it, and that's surely a foul from Jessica. Play continues though, and Holloman takes the two. Oh, Jessica absolutely crunched Rebecca Murray there. 19-2 the US lead. Murray has started in fine form. Holloman though out to 8 personal now for the game, and Vieira comes in for Brazil. Vivi one way, the other way, goes back, thinks of the shot, and then the pressure once more, just like a pressure cooker for Brazil. And they just lose all the power and technique in the shot. Again and again, we're seeing it in this game. And it's such a shame because their all-round play is up there with some of the top teams. It really is. They're moving the ball around. That will not count. 19-2, the US lead. Well, Tony Sampaio, he can be proud of the way the team play. The defence here being unpicked at times as they're having to be overly physical with the USA, and it's costing them in fouls. Murray to inbound the ball for the States. 14 on the shot clock because they're inside the Brazilian half. For any of you that haven't followed wheelchair basketball before, welcome to the game. It's a brilliant game to watch. Rebecca Murray up and down it comes without success that time. Such a good shooter from that sort of range. Each team is allowed 14 points across the five players on court. Each player has a classification which ranks between one, the most impaired on court, and 4.5. Lovely shooting that time for the Brazilians. That's more like it for them. Rosa, it was the number 9. But look at the difference in 2-point shooting between the two. Each player has a classification, one being the most impaired, 4.5 the least. Holloman, 3.5 point player, so she takes up 3.5 of the 14 that the team are allowed across the five players on court. If they go over that, it's not allowed. They can be under 14, of course, if they can or want to make up a team under 14 points, that is permitted. And the type of injuries range from T10, T11, paraplegia, to spina bifida or amputees and all sorts in between. It's a sport that mixes all different styles of impairment, or many different styles of impairment. Schwab, very talented, very experienced, 5-time Paralympian, former wheelchair racer, and always a basketballing superstar, played at the University of Illinois. Rebecca Murray looks for Holloman. The whistle's gone. And it will be US ball from the sideline. The basket didn't count. 2.4 seconds left in the quarter. A big difference between the two currently. 17 points the difference. Schwab, formerly known as Christina Rip. Up goes the shot. It will beat the buzzer, but it doesn't drop in the basket for Rose Holloman. And a very, very impressive opening 10 for the USA. They looked a little bit rusty against Algeria. Tonight, they purely look impressive. USA 21, Brazil 4. The stats on the first quarter, 63% for the USA of their field goals successful. A measly 13 for Brazil. Not good reading for them. Defensive rebounds, 12-5. The USA comfortably in the lead here. There's confirmation at the score at the end of the first quarter. 21-4, the USA lead. And it has been a fantastic first quarter of shooting by the American girls. Steph Wheeler is such an experienced coach. She knows what it takes to win the toughest matches, and at the moment for the USA, this isn't one of them. Murray and the USA back underway, looking for 3 points straight off. Rebecca Murray definitely has the range from there. This won't be a backcourt violation as it came off the ring and back into the US defensive half. Murray that time within range easily and drops the two to open the scoring for the second quarter. Takes her out to 9 points personal for the game. So third Paralympic Games, the 26-year-old. The number nine, Rosa. Geng just blocking out and allowing the team the ball back in the simplest of fashion. The first Paralympic Games, co-captaining the team. Schwab. Murray, Schwab. Two of the best ball carriers in the world, those two. Leah. Good stuff from the Brazilians. They're moving the Americans around well. It's not easy to do. This is one of the best defensive lineups in the world. Leah couldn't get the shot away. And just to give you an idea, 18 shots so far for Brazil and only two made. Getting under the basket, drops the two. 18 shots made. Or generated inside just 11 minutes against the USA tells you how well the Brazilians are moving them. They just can't put the ball in the basket currently. It's 25-4. Rosa, one of the players that has found the basket for Brazil, finds Claire. One-handed shot, lovely shooting that time from Claire. The one-handed shot goes up and drops, and she offers congratulations for the assist. Schwab, Murray, Schwab just floats into the key, doesn't look comfortable in her shot at the moment, Christina Schwab, the two sports superstar. Oh, big crunching foul, that's going to be offensive, it had to be by Leah. Steph Wheeler congratulates Christina Schwab, but to be fair to her, there wasn't much she could do. Leah just went careering into the side of her. The 4.5-pointer against the 2.5-pointer. A mismatch in height, a mismatch in power. Holloman. Look at that. It comes back, though. Thought it was going to go straight through with no trouble to the rim, and it just faded away to the left-hand side. The USA locked on 25. 4-2 in the quarter. Rosa. Claire. One-handed. Doesn't go that time. Holloman can't quite get there. Rosa keeps it in. Hands the ball to Holloman. Holloman darts forward for the USA. The number 15, who is a student at the University of Texas, plays for their wheelchair basketball program. Back to... Oh, what a play by Rebecca Murray. It was Poist who moved the ball on the number 10 at the pivot. And Murray just, with ease, gobbled up the points. 11 personal for the game now, 27-6. It's been a tough Paralympics for the hosts. They had a very difficult pool with the likes of Germany, Canada and Great Britain. Three of the top five teams in the world in their pool. The number 1, 2 and 5 based on the 2014 World Championships. Currently, based on those championships, the US would be ranked 4th. Schwab. But they're playing like a team ranked above that tonight. Schwab once more. Oh, well in by Leah. Schwab's shooting. Not what we're used to. And then the slip from the Brazilians. They're going to have to get it going quite quickly here over the halfway. They do so. They only have 8 seconds to clear halfway. Otherwise, it's known as an 8-second violation. Leah, up goes the shot and good for two. And that's better from Brazil. They were under pressure, but they kept their heads. They kept the shot and the crowd respond. And the crowds here in Brazil really have fallen in love with this game. Of course, Brazil, a proud basketball nation. Their history in wheelchair basketball developing. The men in the quarterfinals, as well as the women, Steph Wheeler. Well, she looks fairly nervous there, but I can't imagine she would be in this one with a 17-point lead so early on. Rosa finds Perla. Perla has done herself proud at these games. Brazil moving the ball around, but look at how high the US defensive line is, and the Brazilians really had no chance there. Desi Miller. Same surname, of course, as the German number four. Desiree Miller and Mareike Miller married. The German number four, a big points player for the German women's team. Timeouts, 2 from 2 for Brazil. Feeling Brazil's going to miss the Paralympic Games when it rolls on to Tokyo. It rolls on from Rio de Janeiro. Brazilian wheelchair basketball will be left in a good state, though they've really performed as well as they could in this competition. 27-10 currently in the quarterfinals here. USA, that's Rebecca Murray. She plays for the Milwaukee Bucks alongside the likes of Desi Miller. And the strong women's league in the USA. Jessica. The core of this Brazilian team are really going places. Not the oldest team either. Ramos is 46, but apart from that, there's plenty of age in the Brazilians to allow them forward to Tokyo as a core squad. Holloman, she's got a few Paralympics left in her at just 20, and she's succeeding in these ones, her second games. Imagine how many she could play in. The 20-year-old makes no mistake from the shot once more. 3.5-point player, averaging 16.8 points per game. And she's currently out to 12 in the quarterfinals, and the USA now over 30. Up and down, well played, Leah. There was a whistle on the play as well. Leah will have an extra shot. Claire gives her a talking to. Saskia Varmadan had Stephanie Wheeler in her ear for a second there. And Leah goes to the line, 31-12, trying to bring it back by one. And does so. Well played, Leah. A foul was called on Holloman, her first foul of the game. Each player, of course, has 5 fouls permitted, and then they have to leave the game. Martin. Leah Martin, 7 points now personal. Claire's there to knock the ball out of play. Sticking up the one hand. Murray, this is her range. Simple. She always looks so good from that angle, just getting outside the key and dropping the two. So rarely does it even clip the rim. Perla. Claire. That's a Murray sort of range where Claire is now. Leah getting in the way of Perla, taking the ball under pressure from Schwab. And it's that sort of pressurised shooting that the Brazilians do slightly let themselves down on. The US, good defence once more, 20 points the difference. Schwab in control of the ball. World silver in 2006 for Schwab. Won gold in 2010. The World Championships in Birmingham, England. Holloman. You can finish the story for yourself when she catches the ball at the moment. She puts it up and goes to 14 for the game. Perla. Cut inside. And up and down it comes. Nothing there for Rosa on that occasion. Murray moves away with the ball for the USA. Uses Schwab to move it on quicker. The co-captain only played just over 2 minutes in the game so far for Schwab. Holloman. She looks for her co-captain. Finds Rebecca Murray once more. 15 points personal for the game, but she won't add to it on this visit. And she goes 7 from 13 from the floor so far. 54%. Leah up and down but rushing. Now to play it goes. Brazil will have the ball. They've got 1.10 seconds left in the second quarter. 1 minute, 10 seconds. Claire, like a soccer throw overhead to the number 9, Rosa. She looks for the long two and again it just clips the rim down in front of Rebecca Murray, and Murray can get the ball moving once more. 4 defensive rebounds for Murray in the game. Holloman spins. Fanias paying her close attention but almost fouling. Here's Geng. Nothing there that time and it bounces hard away and Geng goes flying off into the Brazilian bench to try and retrieve the ball, the 23-year-old. Forward come Brazil. Under 40 seconds left in the half. Perla. Up, hits the ring, comes down. Well caught by Geng. Geng fakes the ball a few times and eventually finds Murray. The fake was more to keep the ball away from Brazilian hands than to trick them. Schwab waiting under the basket. Geng goes herself, gets the foul. No, she doesn't. Saskia Varmadan gives the offensive foul against the number 2. She goes away shaking her head, but Varmadan was in there immediately. She's an incredibly experienced referee, the Dutch lady. See here, the charge from Geng. Offensive foul called. 35-13, heading towards the end of the first half. It's the 2016 Paralympic Games, Rio de Janeiro. It's been a boiling hot day here today. Reaching 35 degrees outside. Of course, this played in the cool climate of the Rio Olympic Arena. And at half time, the USA 35, Brazil 13. Well, that really was a comprehensive first half for the USA. 35-13, 53% of their field goals were successful, just 19% for the Brazilians. 100% though of free throws going for both teams. And looking at the defensive rebounds, 21 played 12, which meant the USA were picking up ball all the time off the Brazilian shot. It means they take the lead into the break. 35-13, USA as it stands are heading for the semi-finals at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. Well, welcome back to the action at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. It's a women's quarterfinal here that we've got coming up for you. The second half, United States of America, 35. Brazil, the hosts, currently struggling on 13. It's a long way back for them in this one. Have not had the greatest of starts in the game in the first two quarters. 53% of field goals falling for the USA, just 19% for the Brazilians. But listen to that crowd. They're here to support their girls, and they'll support them the whole way. The Brazilians have been like that during the Olympic Games and the Paralympic Games. The winner of this go through to the semi-finals, of course, as they aim for a medal. With 1 minute 10 from the action starting back up again. And at the moment, USA have a 35-13 lead. Rosa of Brazil gets the team in green, the hosts back underway. It's the second half, USA in white, Brazil in green. And at the moment, it's a mountain to climb for the Brazilians. Long one-handed shot, that was where they fell away in the first half. Leah unable to match the consistency of the likes of the lady on the ball at the moment, Rebecca Murray. Murray moves forward, overhead pass to Holloman, who juggles. Holloman can't hold on, the crowd cheer. She scored 29 points against France, Holloman, but turns over the ball on that occasion. She's the number 15 in the middle of the shot there. 3.5 point player. And forward comes Ana Aurelia Rosa once more. 28 years of age, finds Leah. Leah has to get out the key quickly because she wasn't putting a shot up. Murray rebounds from her height. That's not the easiest thing to do, to rebound over the top of a taller player. But she did it well. Good hands from Murray. Holloman and Geng just working together. Geng keeping Claire out of proceedings. Desi Miller turns, waits, shoots, and it doesn't drop. She's been slightly off form and looks slightly too relaxed for my liking tonight, Desiree Miller. One of the Americans who have Paralympic experience, five of them in this squad. In fact, eight US Paralympians, five with World Championship experience, in fact. Holloman played at London 2012. She's one of the eight. And she puts the ball in the basket. They lost to the Netherlands at 2012. The Netherlands were my team of the tournament there, in so much as they were exciting. They were inventive and they just played with some real courage and took the game away from the USA in the semi-final. Sorry, in the third, fourth playoff to win the bronze. Of course, both teams lost their semi-finals in London. Lovely shooting from Rosa, 37-15. At the moment, it'll be the USA, by the looks of things, heading towards another semi-final. Up it goes from Murray and out it comes once more. Rosa spins, good pace from her. The last time the USA lost a quarter-final why he didn't make the semi-finals was in 2000 at Sydney, where they ended up having lost their quarter-final, going on to finish fifth, beating Mexico. Becca Murray just calmly calls the play. The USA will restart. Since 2000, it's been gold, gold, and then fourth in London for the USA. Miller, up and down, the whistle on the play. She's a 3.5 point player. She'll have an extra shot, Miller. The foul called against Anna Aurelia Rosa. One foul for her, the first foul for the quarter. And Holloman, Miller and Geng head for the bench. Timeout called, USA 39, Brazil 15. It's called by the Brazilians. It gives Steph Wheeler a chance alongside Trooper Johnson on the right-hand side. And WBA Hall of Famer Johnson. To have a chat with their team. Let's have a listen to what the Brazilians are saying. Americans take their place back on the bench. Miller, the furthest in the action on the free throw line. Up and down for her. Seems to be the only player I regularly see in wheelchair basketball matches, always chewing gum. Perler waits, looks for the shot. That's better from Perler. Kept the form of the shot, but it didn't work out, and it sends Holloman down court. Player who looks quite similar to the Canadian number five, Janet McLaughlin. Plays quite similar to her too, although she's a lower point player than McLaughlin. McLaughlin a 4.5 pointer. Holloman 3.5. Both very successful in front of the basket. Holloman now 18 points for the game. Great rebounding from Gail Geng. Geng at the Pan Am Games last year scored 14 points versus the Brazilians. Holloman over to Miller. Miller catches. Back to Murray, who one-handed shots, and it wasn't going anywhere. On that occasion, the number five returning to the game is Farias for the Brazilians, a 30-year-old from São Caetano do Ovideias. Perler, 8 points against Canada, 29% she hit during the Group A action. Leah turns, Holloman, that is superb defending by Rose Holloman. She's not just a brilliant offensive player, she's an excellent defender too. Now coming into the game for the USA, Schwab, Schneider, who performed well against the Algerians, very experienced player returning from giving birth to her second child. To return to Paralympic action, Claire inbounds the ball, and the other player coming in was the number 33. It's Mackenzie Soldan from Hemlock in Michigan. Brilliant shooting from Rosa. Sol Dan is a former tennis Paralympian. Schwab. Oh, brutal pass to Rebecca Murray, who won't thank her for the pass. Gets the foul, but Schwab passed it like an absolute rocket here to the left shoulder of Rebecca Murray. Murray. Leah comes away. This way and that for Leah. Schwab just keeping her on the outside. The US know if they keep Brazil that sort of range, they struggle to put the ball in the basket. If they can't get inside this American defence, Holloman might be fortunate here. Yes, she is, because Murray's picked up the ball and is driving the left-hand side of the paint. Oh, off Rosa, and great steal from Leah. There's fight in this Brazilian team yet. Soldan just getting in the way. Perla coming through. Falias, lovely take up. It goes down. It goes. Brazil are here. And Brazil are proving what they can do. Albeit they're behind by 23. But their all-round play is something to get excited about for the future of wheelchair basketball in South America. Holloman. Every team have to start somewhere. Oh, Leah off Holloman. Out of play it goes. 6 seconds on the shot clock. But that's gone now because it'll be a turnover. Steph Wheeler won't be concerned. More likely to be impressed by the Brazilians and their tenacity. Timeout called. Steph Wheeler's got points to make. Be patient, let them do all the movement. And USA do need to be patient because Brazil are the ones that are chasing the game. They can control the game from here. Holloman 18 points, Murray 15, Desi Miller just the 5, Leah 7, Rosa 6, and Vivi quiet tonight, just a couple of points for her. But Holloman and Murray have been in divine form. The Americans. 42-19. Rosa. Perla. It's sometimes just limit players getting in and around the key. Just two players getting anywhere near the key. Okay, now three as Leah gets in and gets the buzzer beater. Well played. It makes a huge difference when they threaten the Americans in and around the key. They were sitting deep for a long time there. Not long left to go in this third quarter. 42-21. Murray. Leah out to 9 points for the game. Holloman. Rattles around and the Brazilians could bring it within 20 here. Leah. Rosa. USA definitely know they're in a game in this quarterfinal. Leah puts the shot up and oh, it goes in and comes out. Now Schneider, 4.5 point player, 14 points at 44% against the Algerians from the floor. Holloman gets stuck on the chair of Leah, who is penalised there for the hold. You see the referee grabbing hold of his arm to signify the hold. And changes once more. Miller, Geng, both returning. There is Gail Geng. University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign student, so part of that. Stephanie Wheeler. Led program at the University of Illinois in her time. Here's Rosa. Soldan was another player to go out. Darlene Hunter's coming. Rosa up, doesn't go. 42-21. Here comes Miller, just sauntering forward. Spins the ball to Geng. Geng out to Murray. Murray rarely shows that she feels pressure at all. Holloman in she goes for two, and that was well worked between Miller and Holloman to pick up the basket for the Americans and stretch it back to 23 points now. Versus China, Holloman grabbed herself 11 points personal. Tonight she's at 20. The Chinese, of course, were another team that made the quarterfinals, squaring off against Great Britain for a place in the semis. Up and nothing for Claire. China finished third in Group B, the US group. Great Britain second in Group A after a three-way tie, including Germany and Great Britain and Canada. 46-21 now as we head towards the last 30 seconds of the quarter. Rosa Claire goes driving into the key, and that's better from the Brazilians. Leah in there too, gets the shot up and gets the shot down, and that was magnificent from the team in green, the hosts. I tell you what, Claire's drive into the key there made all the difference, because it made the Americans follow her and think about another player other than just Leah around the key, and that opened up the opportunity for the number 12. Rebecca Murray doesn't need to get near the key. She's lethal from all angles. She can't put the ball away on that occasion, though. The buzzer going, signifying the end of the third. The USA, it's been an exciting quarter of wheelchair basketball here at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games, and there is the score. USA 46, Brazil 23. Well, the US total field goals have dropped slightly, and Brazil have just lifted theirs. 11 from 47 from theirs for 23%. Rose Holloman continuing to have an absolute blinder. But the Brazilians are not giving in here. They're on home territory. They're a really feisty bunch, this Brazilian women's wheelchair basketball team. Rebecca Murray knows that all too well. But Holloman, again and again, refuses to buckle under the pressure from the Brazilians, and it means we've got a 23-point difference in the game. Murray and Miller start things off for the team in white, the USA. Desiree Miller can't get the shot to fall once more. She's hitting 33% from the field tonight for 5 points. She hit 24 points against the Chinese, and the Brazilians open the scoring. 12 from 18 she got against China in the group. Desi Miller, Leah tonight is enjoying herself, the number 12. If Brazil are going to go out at this stage, at least Martin, 13 points at 40%. Holloman, there's no stopping her currently. Number 15, 22, 11 from 16 at 69%. She's even out shooting Gail Geng, who has 67%. Geng, though, only making 2 from 3 so far. Holloman, many more shots and many more successes. Rosa. Leah goes in and tries to rebound. Perla comes across and tries to keep it alive, but Saskia Varmadan says no, sorry. That's gone out of play. The crowd don't like it. I think the bench don't like it either, and they've got to be careful. Very experienced referee and umpiring team here. Max Kindervater, Alexander Lapont and Saskia Varmadan have been around for years, these three. The bench obviously just made a comment that didn't go down too well. Miller to Murray. Murray back to Miller, who sits on the pivot and finds Holloman, who fades inside. Oh, that's well played to Darlene Hunter. She can't put the points away, Hunter, on this occasion. The one-point player who won a gold at the 2010 World Championships. Leah goes barging through. Oh, and it's gone for her. I thought that was going to go against there. Gail Genk picks up the foul. It'll be her second personal foul of the game. She's allowed five before she gets sent from the court, and at the moment there's no danger of that for any of the players on the US team. Only picked up three fouls in the game for Brazil. Their highest number is two, with three players on two apiece. Rosa Santana and Leah Perla. Good shape from the shot for her. Technique-wise, I'd say she's probably the best shooter in the team. Not necessarily picks up the most points. She tends to take fewer number of shots. But the look of her shot tends to be, or looks a better technique than some of the one-handed efforts which can come from the likes of Leah. Rosa, lovely pass to Leah. Leah slightly rushed. Perla won it back, puts it up again. Leah and Rosa that time can't out-rebound Holloman, who just reaches above the little six. Two-pointer for Brazil. Here's Gail Genk out to Murray. Murray on the angle, and there's only one answer for Rebecca Murray when she gets the ball in that sort of position. That is her bread and butter. 50-25, the USA lead. Perla. This way, that way, over Miller. Doesn't fall. 0-8 for Perla at the moment. The Hooter goes. There will be some new additions to the Brazilians. Vivi comes in once more, as does the number 8, Ramos Rosalia. 46 years of age, the 1.5-point player. There she is. She's averaging just 0.3 points per game. She's played in every game of the competition so far. Most of these teams do utilise each player across all the games, although the USA, Erskine's only played one game so far. Megan Blunt just the two, although she was fantastic against Algeria. Hasn't featured yet tonight. Megan Blunt had a nice birthday present against the Algerians in being the star turn for the US. Here's Holloman. Miller in the key a long time as the shot goes up from Murray, and again, that's where she likes the shots to come from, Rebecca Murray. I cannot tell you enough about how good this girl is. 2012 Women's College Division Player of the Year in the USA. Vivi, Perla, 52-25. Brazil have got almost certainly too much to do here. It would be the comeback of the century if they manage this one. But trust me, that man's team will not give up fighting. Haven't seen any of the number 13, Meyer, in this game at all. She averages 4.5 points per game during the competition. She's appeared in just a couple of matches as Miller sinks the two. Well played, Desi Miller. 10.5 points a game for her. Played the under 25 World Championships in 2011, where she won a gold medal. It was the first ever World Championships for under 25 women. And Miller there was the MVP of the competition. A hugely successful innovation from the world governing body of wheelchair basketball to bring in junior world championships into the women's game. The original one won by the USA, then Great Britain, who finished third from memory at the 2011 edition, went and won the gold at 2015 in Beijing, China. Timeout called and the score, USA 54, Brazil 25. Yet again, the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games has fantastic audiences. They've been fully engaged. Not quite a full stadium tonight, but not many empty seats at all. And the noise they're making. The Brazilian women managed to have 11,000 people come and watch them a couple of games ago. 11,000 people really is a brilliant advert for the Paralympic Games, the movement of the Paralympics. And the quality of the Paralympics as well, because the competition has been superb and it's only going to get better going in towards the semi-finals. It might be the end of the road for the Brazilian women tonight. The Brazilian men will remain in the competition into the quarter-finals. Vivi. Farias tries to... In fact, it was the number 8 Ramos, the 46-year-old, who tried to get the shot away. Vivi collects the rebound. Here is Vivi. Miller asking questions of her offense, keeping her at range here. One-handed shot from Vivi and taken comfortably. Number 5 is Darlene Hunter, the 34-year-old, who picked up the rebound. The whistle goes on the plate. Of course, all these women's team aiming for the gold medal match on the 16th of September. .423 left to go. As Jessica Santana returns and Perla makes way. Well, if we don't see Perla again, she can head out of her home games with a lot of credit. I said her highlight was winning a bronze medal at the Parapan Am Games in 2015. I think that highlight may have changed to playing on home soil in a Paralympic Games. And although they haven't come close to the Americans here, they've pushed them at times and they've generated a few weaknesses at times in the USA. The USA almost certain to head into the semi-finals, but there are some areas they still need to work on. They don't look unbeatable, this team. Leah. Vivi. The movement of the Brazilians, and they open up the US defense once more. And the shot goes away. Darlene Hunter forced Vivi out. Vivi refused to ignore the opportunity of the shot. Goes to 4 points personal for the game. 56-27. Here's Holloman in the paint a long time, but sinks the two just before the referees started to get interested in the amount of time she'd been sat in there. 26 points personal for the game now. Algeria with the lowest score. The United States managed to keep in the pool, scoring just 15 points, which really is a tiny amount for a wheelchair basketball game. The Dutch managed 50. China 36 and France 37. So 27 from the Brazilians. Not a million miles off par. with the teams that are around there sort of ranking in the world. The likes of the Chinese and the French, and Lia makes it 29 now. Number 12 goes to 15 points for the game. The highest points total in the competition so far. 3 points more than against the Argentinians. Oh, well played, Jessica. That was magnificent. She hit 33% against the Canadians. She'll remember baskets like that against the USA. And here come Brazil once more. Vivi has the ball, gets the foul. 58-31. And this will be very positive for whoever the US go into a semi-final against. Because Stephanie Wheeler is having to bring her team over and talk things through here. Their defence is not watertight at the moment. Let's listen to what Wheeler says. Well, interesting. She said, you've got to fix this right now or tomorrow is going to be real tough. Now, what she meant there, obviously, tomorrow actually isn't the semi-finals, but she's thinking ahead. She knows her team here are going to make the semi-finals. And what Wheeler's concerned about is if Brazil can unpick the American offense, turn the ball over with ease in a semi-final against a better team, the USA are going to have holes in their game. Wheeler's concerned. The USA currently, although they're going to win this quarterfinal in some style, there's question marks being asked during timeouts. It's not just rolling towards the semi-finals with glee, although Rebecca Murray helps matters by dropping in the two. She's such a cool customer. Be honest, she's one of my favourite players to watch in the women's game. 60-31 the score, just for the level of consistency. Wouldn't even describe Murray as a necessarily an exciting player in her style. Go Team USA is the call from the fans. But where she generates excitement is the shots just go down again and again and again and again. And Murray now 24 points for the match so far. Overall, a great performance. Once more, we haven't seen much of Christina Schwab in the latter stages of the game. We didn't see much of her against Algeria. 15 minutes for Schwab this evening, the co-captain. Murray turns. She's played 30 minutes. She's got 9 defensive rebounds. She's got a double-double. 10 rebounds. 24 points. Lia puts the ball up. Lia back into her chair in the upright position. She'll go to the line. 31-61. 5 fouls from the USA. 3 in the quarter for the Brazilians. So every time the US foul the Brazilians now, lovely shooting from Lia. Every time the US foul the Brazilians from now on in this one, they will go to the line. They bring it back within 30. And one more as well from Lia. Well, you cannot ask for more from this team. She's hit 100% of her free throws. Brazil have only had the 3 this evening. For any Brazil fans out there, give a warm round of applause to this team. Don't worry that they haven't medalled here in Rio, because they're the sort of team that with some work and development could well be pushing for a semi-final spot in Tokyo or beyond. 63-33 now. The USA are going to head into the semi-final. Another semi-final for the US. They've not missed a Paralympic semi-final in quite some time, since the year 2000, the turn of the millennium. They finished fifth in Sydney and at Homebush. As they had to watch their arch rivals Canada win the gold. They then snatched it off them 4 years later. Murray, up and down it comes. We're inside the last minute. 11 from 22 and 50% for Murray from field goals this evening. 100% from her free throws. Nothing at all from her three-point efforts. She's tried a couple. Here comes Vivi. Oh, Vivi, what a way to finish the tournament. She's been a crowd favourite. And she then goes and sinks a long two to take her to 6 points personal for the game. 63-35. Geng. Well, Brazil's run towards a medal in the Paralympic Games is going to come to an end this evening as Geng puts the two away with 5.7 left in the game and the foul on the play as well. The Brazilians' run in the competition will come to an end. They'll have to play off for positions. 5-8. Geng compounds the misery for the Brazilians, 66-35, but they have been a thorn in the side of the USA at times this evening. Timeout called on the game. Steph Wheeler will talk things through with her team once more. And the US seal yet another semi-final. That said, in the Paralympic Games and the World Championships in 2012 and 2014, they've not managed to make their way through a semi-final. The last time they won a semi-final in either of those two events was 2010 in Birmingham. Look at Vivi with this shot. Lovely scenes from the Brazilians. Jessica finishing off the competition for Brazil. They lose the quarterfinal, but they win a lot of hearts here, the Brazilians. They have worked their socks off against the USA. In the end, it's those fans from the US that will continue in this competition and will aim for a medal. The final score, the United States of America 66, Brazil 35. Congratulations from the referees and the umpires to the Brazilians. The Americans can look forward to a semi-final. Rebecca Murray tonight was absolutely outstanding for her team. 24 points alongside Rose Holloman. Holloman 28. She hit 70% from her field goals. 14 of 20. But Murray, 50% from the floor. 100% from free throws. The Brazilians are saying, well, it's not really goodbye because they will play in front of the home crowd again in the crossovers. There's the confirmation of the result. USA 66, Brazil 35. And here are the statistics. 53% from the floor for the USA. as they hit 31 of 58, just 25 for the Brazilians. But 64 shots got away. Tells you actually how well they played overall, ignoring their shooting. In the end, it wasn't enough, and Brazil go out in the quarterfinals. Look at that for a semi-final lineup. Europe, wheelchair basketball, doing itself proud. Germany versus the Netherlands. The two European heavyweights go head-to-head for a spot in the final. And Great Britain, their first ever Paralympic semi-finals, and they play the USA. The USA are looking to make their way to another Paralympic gold medal match. But Great Britain will know they've got every single chance of making their way to their first ever gold medal game in their first ever Paralympic semi-final. It's all to play for in the women's wheelchair basketball. It's really hotting up, not only the temperature outside, but here at the Rio Olympic Arena. And the women's quarterfinals are done and dusted. We know who the semi-finalists are. Brazil say goodbye in the women's quarterfinals at the wheelchair basketball. For the USA, it's the fourth semi-final in four Paralympics. We wait to see how they go against Great Britain in the semi-finals.